big helicopter. It's taking water on over to Reno, up to the north here. There's a giant fire. A couple of our players can't even make it here today due to the fire. Nice day. Shit, about 100 degrees, but it's cloudy out. Nice mild breeze to cool us off. And we're going to have a game, but unfortunately, like I said, a couple of our players are not going to be able to make it today. They're stuck. They got roads blocked. There's massive fire going on.
Normally, I say hit that like and subscribe. Please put out your forest fires.
Right. Forest fire is going to... Half of our players aren't going to make it because of the forest fire. Up in Reno, man. I got all kinds of fires springing up. Last week, the fire was over here, just over the hill. Crazy, man. Crazy. Good to get a good warm-up game in. Okay. So, everybody, we're going to play 21. A couple of our guys are delayed by a fire up in Reno. And traffic is just held up for miles. Roads are being blocked. This should be a lot better than playing at the Mac only because, like I say, if you're not having fun, why play? And so if you'll understand when you watch my previous video I put out, my coaching video, called Firestorm Times 3. So we'll play. We'll go ahead. We'll hoop. We'll do what we can. Hopefully a couple of our players can make it out. Like I say, just have a good time and just ball. That's what it's about. But it's 100 degrees. 100 degrees. It's cloudy. It's a little cloudy today, but it's going down a mild breeze, not like last week. So we should have, it should be a great time just being outdoors. Because I love when it's a little breezy, because if there was no breeze, I mean, you would feel that 100 degrees. Because it is 100. But we got a nice shade, so I don't have the sun in my eyes, so I should be able to make some of my three-pointers today. And, go from there, you know, just get better each game. All right, everybody, let's do this. Hardly any wind right now. Perfect time to shoot a three. This is what I look for, man. This is what I look for. Dan, oh. It's four. At least I'm on the board. It's better than having nothing. come on! No way. Fucking overheated, you mean?
You gotta be smarter than that.
It's like 8 or 9 to 4. So just getting warmed up. You guys can see it's a nice day out. Not a lot of wind. Got Winston out. Camera's probably cutting off my head. I'm gonna crank it up a little higher in the next game. So just having a good time, man. I don't care if you play 1-on-1, 5-on-5. As long as you're hooping, that's all that matters. As long as you're hooping.
Oh!
Somebody always complaining around here. I'm surprised they didn't complain about me coming to play at night. I got a night ball. Pretty good. See by the bench? Alright. I gotta get serious. No more screwing around. Back east, 10 feet high.
The whole court would be caged then up east.
Yeah, I played in a cage court. I prefer it.
I played in one of those caged with the roof.
Yeah.
It felt like hell in a cell. But for real, like that shit was intense. No foul.
Just playing a cage, man.
Everybody all up in each other.
Like shit. A street ball.
Pretty much.
Miss because I'm not a good side shooter. Although a few weeks ago I had three in a row on the side, so maybe focus is my issue. Maybe I just need to focus more, you know?
I started out only shooting from the sides.
Yeah.
Like, I will only shoot from the sides. Like, my coach used to beg me to take out the shots.
And then don't forget the bank shots.
Mm-hmm.
Film. And then last video, people are going to think I'm an ass, but I had to highlight some mistakes on the video. I had to. Because I just can't. I know my mistakes. I don't need people pointing them out. I know what I do wrong. And I'll fix it. Especially in a game, I'll fix it. But I'm not. When I'm playing drop and basketball, I just don't give a fuck. These guys aren't on my team. You guys are. Or something. So I don't know. It's not too bad, I guess. It's a good game for video.
We weren't playing about putting out the forest fires, goddammit. Cut this shit out.
So everybody, I don't know if you can hear me through the wind or not, but Carson City has no basketball leagues. It was Scott's choice at the MAC. I'm not trying to be rude or anything like that, but Carson City needs more sports. And if we're open, we're open, whether you postpone the league or not. So there's no basketball right now going on in Carson City. However, I want to let everybody know the Phantoms basketball team will carry on. We are going to register in a league in Reno. There are three leagues in Reno right now, three different facilities. We're going to find a league that suits our team the best. So coming up in August, maybe September, we should be competing up in the city of Reno. So that's the good news I want to tell you guys. Even though the Carson City MAC is not going to boast a league this year and we got canceled twice, I have to do something about it. I got to get my guys competing. We've been practicing for over a year together,
for this moment so we could put all our skills together and compete in the league. So we're going to be playing in the league coming up, and I'm going to register the team this summer sometime in July, and then I believe two or three of the leagues start in August and September. So we should be playing a full season this summer or fall, and so look for that, because I will be filming our basketball games from the bench or whatever, and so that you guys will be able to see full games on YouTube, not just practice games. But for now, James and I are going to play 21, or what you'd say, what you call one-on-ones, one-on-one. It's always a lot of fun. I enjoy playing with James. I have a lot of respect for playing against him. He's good defensively and offensively. I do like the challenge, but it's time to up the ante, everybody. So expect more points to be scored in this game. This is Lord Rick, founder, captain, team coach of the Phantoms sports organization. It's all right. I just don't. I try not to play with them. One time I had it in my pocket and I like went across the river. And I pulled it up. Playing basketball, being in there, getting stabbed by him and shit. Like, man, I need to be more careful. I shot it. I was thinking, here I brought my stereo and I haven't put on any fucking music. Come on.
There we go. I have to pair it, man. All right. Now for the music. Yeah, it was good seeing Johnny. Because, I mean, I didn't know, man. That fire got close to his house. It's like, holy shit, dude. Alright, I guess we'll play. It's trying to pair with it. So I'll play. I'm gonna try to put on mute. It's kind of the point of me bringing the boombox and then I don't put it on. So I want to try to get it working. To admit that to people. I'm like, man, I'm not going to pretend to be LeBron James. Nobody can be King James, you know? Shannon would show late, but he's like driving on a journey right now. It's like, that sucks, dude. You gotta drive home, man. He's gotta go east before he can come back to Carson and loop around. You guys haven't seen nothing yet. Wait till these mountains burn. Lost it. Trying not to shoot the sun anymore. Can't see. Everybody's like, you wear sunglasses, it doesn't matter. Sun still fucks my eyes on. These are fucking strip fucking sunglasses. Doesn't matter. I hate the sun. Saved it from going on the rocks, baby. Alright. Try this again. Oh, I should have missed that layup. That was my fault. I'll take ownership of that mistake. Should have made that basket. Sometimes I make them all and sometimes I miss them. And I definitely gotta get used to playing back outside too. It's been a while. I was getting pretty good out here. In September, I was winning. I beat Zach and shit. I don't know what happened with Zach. Thank you.
Up there, but I didn't. James won, everybody. 7:21. Still good game. I was telling him I had a little bit of a run where, you know, I got 7 points in a row and cold turkey. So consistency is something maybe I need to work on, but I'll criticize myself before someone else will do it, and I will fix it. I'm the coach. And so I just got to be more focused, a little bit more on my shots, because when you miss 10 shots, it's 20 points right out the window. And I lost 20 points, and then all of a sudden I had found my shot, but by then it's too late. If somebody's got 20 points and you only got a few points, chances are they're going to win. Doesn't mean you can't come back. It just means you got to work twice as hard. So it's a good run. We'll play another game soon. I got to drink my Kratom water, and I'll be back, guys. We're going to play a third game. I got my stereo working, so we'll have a little music, guys, just to kind of weed out the wind a little.
here it's gonna be like 110 degrees out here. Then I won't complain.
Thank you.
Okay.
Make sure he's still recording. Which is alright by me. I don't like short games. Was the camera, everybody. Just don't want it to be in anyone's way in the court. Okay. Put it right there.
Thank you.
sour, married to the game, but she broke her vows. That's why my bars are full of broken bottles, and my nightstands are full of open Bibles. I think about more than I forget, but I don't go around fire expecting not to sweat. And these niggas know I lay them down, make your bed. Bitches try to keep me while I'm down, I break your leg. On a triple beam, I'm sticking to the script. You niggas skipping scenes. Be good or be good at it. Fucking right, I got my gun, semi-automatic. Yeah, put the dick in their mouth so I guess this fuck what they say. I'm high as a bitch, up in the way, man. I come down in a couple of days. Okay, you want me up in the cage, then I'll come out in beast mode. I got this world stuck in the same combination.
I certainly respect Big James. He played very good defensively. He had some wonderful three-pointers. We had we had some games that were sort of close. The last game was 10-21, the one before 18-21. So, you know, we have a light, mild wind here, so it's a double rim. So you can see what happens is it'll spit the ball out. So even if you have a good shot, the double rim sometimes causes a little difficulty shooting. Then you throw this, we got the sun out to the west, and then we got about a 10 to 15 mile an hour wind. So So we're going to have to get used to playing outside again, but next week we'll have more guys. Some of our team got stuck up in Reno due to a fire, a brush fire. Traffic's not moving, so they could not make it. So we'll have more guys next week, but man, got 100 degrees today, but it feels good to be outdoors. I welcome the exercise. Good run, James. You came through this week. Appreciate your loyalty. Thank you for coming out. It don't matter if one or two guys comes out. Main thing is we're having fun. We're working out. We're getting practice in for the great news, which is our team is going to a competition up in Reno. We're going to register for it, and we're going to compete. This is what we work for, guys. So I'll see you next week, Wednesday. Peace out. It's Lord Rick. Oh, and one more thing. As you guys see, I'm bringing music back to playing outdoors. That's something we can't do at the Mac. But we can have music here. We can smoke bud. We can do whatever we want, man. The world's ours. So is basketball. Hey, Winston. I had to push it all down the wax, man. I wasn't getting anything before. I pushed the wax down against the coils. Now I got a little bit of wax. Wasn't working before. I was like, what the hell, dude? Nothing was coming in or out. That's why I hate these pens, because you got to really keep an eye on the wax. Because if it gets above the coil, sometimes it won't burn. Yeah, I mean, we'll enter the competition. You know, I can't say we're going to win first. I can't say we're going to win last. But we should at least try to compete. We should try to go, and we should try to take our team. I mean, if we play in league in August and September, then we'll play in league come up in February. So we'll be able to play two seasons this year of basketball. You know, I don't know when I'm going to move. I'm thinking about moving next year. So I know I'll be here for league for next year, but I don't know after that. It's hard to say. I mean, I'm going to have my team. I wanted to have my team for 10 years, but Carson City, dude, has changed. And I've lived here a long time in Nevada. I'm not, like, new here, you know? And this place has changed, man. Even the sports has changed. They still won't bring football, hockey, or lacrosse or anything. And basketball in Carson's once a year for a couple months. And they were going to do a 3-on-3 league, and they canceled that. I don't know why. He's like, we can't get refs. I'm the one that pays the ref, dude. Why can't you get refs? We personally pay for the ref. Each of us gives like $3 for the ref. No big deal. $3. So the ref gets like $25 because each player gives $3. We got like 8 guys. You know what I'm saying? I'll throw in an extra dollar or whatever. Yeah. But they don't want to do the 3-on-3 league. And now they want to postpone our season till like February of next year. But I go to Reno, and there's 3 facilities that you can register for teams starting in the July-August competition. So I think in another month or 2 months, our team will be playing in a league. For sure. For sure. And like I said, I'll drive to Reno. Not an issue. Not an issue. As long as the guys want to play. You know, it's like, don't waste my time, because we're going to be joining. We're a team. This isn't like a joke. We're competing against some really good ballers. We got something to go prove out there and go play the game, you know. This isn't like pick up basketball at the Mac where we're just fucking around. Because at the Mac, I fuck around a lot. I'm just there to laugh and have a good time with my friends. It's like if I was trying against you, dude, you'd be on the ground. I'd steal that ball and fucking mow over you. I'm not going to do that shit. We're not in league. You're not my enemy, you know what I'm saying? But just a bunch of kids playing on a court. You know, it's like, come on, man, I got this kid, that kid. I don't want to cover this kid. What if that kid runs into me and gets hurt? Then the parents are going to be pissed off. Mm-hmm. You ran over my son. I'm going to sue you. You know, that kind of shit. So, and it does happen at the back. So it's like, come on, dude. That's why I love playing here. Because I think we can take our team. This could be our team's place for practice for now. And then when we got league, we'll have league on top of it. So we'll be playing probably basketball twice a week almost. We'll have a practice and league games. So we're going to play a lot of basketball coming up. And I'm not joking about it. It's why I've kept this team together as long as I have. Because I want to give you guys an opportunity to play. I want you guys to play in league. I want you guys to show your talents off. You know, me as a coach, I just watch you guys. I'll play and shit, but I watch because it's my job to see where talents lie. And some guys on our team are pretty talented players. But do they need practice? Yeah. Just like me, I need practice. I'm old. If I don't practice, I lose my touch. It took me a couple games out here just to get used to the rim. So it takes time. It does take time. You don't become a good basketball player overnight. But see, at my age, I'm a little bit more, I got wisdom when I play. So there are times I will wait. Like last week, a guy tried to block me. I let him jump up and then I shot it. I was like, dude, I know you're going to try to block me. I'm patient. I don't force the ball. So it's like, that's why I'm such a good defensive player. Because I'm not going to, if I'm covered, I'm not going to shoot it. Mm-hmm. Even though I could probably shoot it and hit rim or make it, I'm not going to risk it for our team. I'll just pass it off to you or pass it off to James or whatever. Because I don't care. I'll be a kingmaker. I'll give you the ball all day long if you want to put it in. I don't care. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's whoever opens going to get the ball. Who's ever open. I tried to wait here today. It's another reason why I was, like, stalling. Because I was hoping
anybody came up.
Yeah, because there was, like, a couple guys that were fucking stuck in Reno. And I figured, you know what? It might take them an extra. Because it's, even if you're stuck and have to go through Fernley, it should only take an extra, like, 45 minutes, an hour. So I figured, so if you show 6:30, okay, that's fine. But nobody showed. So I'm going to assume that nobody else is coming. That's all right. We'll go. I mean, it's fine. I'm going to go eat anyways. I got a fucking barbecue chicken cooking in the slow cooker right now. What I do is I put it in the slow cooker all day long, the whole chicken, in seasoning and barbecue sauce. And then when you come home after basketball, that shit just pulls apart. The chicken just, you just fucking grab it with a fork and it pulls right off. It's awesome. So one thing I can do is cook. Man's got to eat. If you're going to play basketball, you got to eat healthy. All right, Winston, I'm going to get your leash off, buddy. I just wanted to put this wax down. All right, everybody, we're heading out. Shull's Ranch. Beautiful place to play. We'll be back next week, Wednesday. I'm going to post these games on YouTube. I hope you guys like them. This is a good basketball. You know what I mean? It's just real chill. Just real chill like you guys. I'm going to get my boombox, but real chill here. Real chill atmosphere. Beautiful scenery. Nice locals. Just a great place to play. It's the only place in Carson City that's not vandalized right now. It's a fairly new court. Everything else has potholes, missing hoops. City won't fix it. And more people are moving up here, building thousands of houses. And the crime's getting bad. And a little mountain town like this is becoming a mountain city. And this is one of the last courts to play on, guys. And I'm privileged to be here. So I'm going to head on out. A good night, everybody. I got a barbecue chicken cooking in the slow cooker. Honey barbecue with brown sugar. All the Italian seasonings. When I come home, the breasts, the legs, the wings will all come apart. It's been cooking since this morning. So good basketball, great times. We'll be here next week with the rest of the team, guys. These are kind of warm-up games. We're going to join the competition up in Reno. You can see the Phantoms play. I'll tell you where to see us. If you want to watch games, we can watch them on YouTube. But we will be joining Summer and Fall League into Winter League. So we're going to play a lot of basketball coming up. This is Lord Rick. Check out our site. Paranormal, Ghost Society, Phantoms Association on Facebook, Angel of Thy Night on YouTube, and the paranormalghostsociety.org/pgsphantoms.htm. Peace out, everybody. Good night.